Okay, this is race two of North America Racing League GT3 AM, and this is at Sebring. It's a night race. Managed to qualify in 28th position with a 159.774, which is about a second and a half off of pole position. So a little better than the first race in terms of qualifying, but not by a whole lot. But progress nonetheless, so we'll take it and see how we do. This is the first of, I think, like four races that I'm going to be racing at Sebring in this silly season. So this is really, I'm looking at it as a warm-up and an opportunity to race some really good racers and see where I can end up. But the real fun is going to come a little bit later when we do the 12-hour on Saturday. That's going to be a pretty incredible race with my team and having a little bit of fun with that dynamic. So this is definitely practice for that, and we'll see if I can reap some benefits. After last race, I think I finished 32nd, so I'm in 32nd position. I have 17 points, so I didn't get zeroed out at least. So I definitely need to score some good points if I'm going to move up a little bit in the standings in this one. Again, really quality race car drivers. Even though it's AM, there are some, you know, mid 2K I-rating drivers at the head of this field. So it's no slouches in this field for sure.
B28. The track temp is 64. The air temp is 63 Fahrenheit.
Got the race lab apps back up and running.
Follow car number 69 in the left column.
So you do have standings and relative information this race. The track map is seeming to be what was causing the CPU load problems, or at least the bulk of them. So turning that off, as useful and fun as that is, seems to be preserving my ability to race.
Catch up to car number 69.
Forty-six car field, I believe. So this actually works out fairly well. All of my stints in the 12 hours are going to be night stints. So this is really good practice for me. It can be tough to see around this place at night. Especially with all the lights from other cars and round track, casting weird shadows and stuff. You could turn off some of that with the settings in iRacing, but I choose not to for the most part. simply because of the immersion factor. It's kind of nice to kind of see the shadows and the dances with light and stuff. Feel like you're in, really in the race car.
Okay, Chip. Stay calm. Focus. Go, go, go! There's an incident in Cunningham. Yellow flag. There's an incident in Tower. Looks like it's Braun. Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate. There's an incident in turn one.
So that was a crazy first lap. I lost sight of my braking marker coming into the hairpin and got a little bit of bump love going on.
There's an incident in Le Mans, yellow flag. Incident in turn one, 329, yellow flag. Incident in turn 5. It looks like Harris.
I didn't pay close attention to it, but it looks like it's actually transitioning to morning.
Yellow flag.
Turn. So many ways through sunset, even if you completely mess it up.
Okay, Jim. Relax, focus, keep it smooth. V27. Your lap time was 201.51. Incident in the hairpin. I think your pit window for fuel should open after 30 minutes and closes at about 34 minutes. There's an incident in turn 1. Looks like it's long V26.
This is why I need a rig when I travel to Austin. I was in Austin this last week for work.
Yellow flag.
So I got no practice over the last 4 days. Which is a little embarrassing. Come out here with these guys and like... I mean no disrespect. It's just the way the cards fell for me this week.
The gap in front has increased. It's now about 1.1.
must have done some damage to the car, because my aero, I should be keeping up with these guys because we're all in a fixed setup, and I am definitely not.
There's an incident in the hairpin. We think it might be Willis.
What you talking about, Willis?
Yellow flag. Watch out. The guy behind's reeling you in. The gap's now 5.1. Incident in Fangio chicane. We think it might be Willis.
That was an unfortunate event. Just realized that anybody that isn't a boomer like me completely missed that different strokes reference. Gary Coleman, man.
Incident in Christensen. Looks like it's Brown, 23rd place. An incident in Tower. Okay, Chip. The pit window is now open.
almost over rotated it.
Second place.
An incident in Gen Debian. It looks like Harris. Yellow flag, caution. Yellow flag, watch out, there's an incident in turn 5. incident in. Sunset, it looks like it's Michael. Watch your speed. Pit lane speed limit is 45 miles per hour. 300 feet. 100 feet. Your exit's clear. Watch the white line. Behind is now 1.3 seconds. Alright Chip, there's the car exit in the pits, heads up. B25. B23. emergency car exit in the pits. B22. Leader Ferretti is pitting. Front is now 1.2. Wait till your apexes. Wait for the chances to come, mate. B20. Sector 2 is 0.30 off the pace.
It's pretty sloppy. I can do better. Steer cost me speed on the straight.
The gap behind is now 1.9 seconds.
Too much speed coming in. That'll do that. 5 more laps of fuel. I hope that's good news.
I got no idea.
Five minutes left. P19. Front is now 2.4 seconds. Tenths off the pace in sector 3. Sector 1 is 1.2 seconds off the pace. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes. Sector 2 is 0.33 off the pace. White flag, one more lap. Okay, Chip, we estimate you've got 5 minutes of fuel remaining.
There's an incident in tower.
Behind is now 2.8 seconds. It's a big pile up in turn one. There's an incident in Christensen. We think it might be Kingcott.
Woo!
19. There's the finish. Good drive.
Top 20 hype. In this crowd, that isn't a bad finish. Not a bad finish at all.
Your speed limit in the pits. Feet. 100 feet.
Yahoo! We'll call that a wrap. Well, as far as finishes go, I don't think I could possibly be happier. This is a tough set. A good group of racers, especially towards the top, to have a 47 car field, and to wind up finishing P19 from a P28 start. That is just not bad at all. Fastest lap was a 159.469, which is, I think, my fastest lap ever on this track, which probably isn't something I should say out loud in fast company, but that's really good. Felt pretty good. And other than that one little bobble where I missed my breaking point and got tapped from the rear, I didn't have any incidents other than that one 4X incident at the hairpin. So all in all, I managed the race fairly well. I managed to actually be a lot faster after the pit stop than I was before the pit stop. Of course, a lot of congestion early in the race, and then got behind some guys that were a little slower. I think there were like 5 or 6 cars there that ultimately it was just smarter to go ahead and pit in. And the guy in front of me did the same thing because he realized that another lap around the track with those guys was just going to slow us down. So pitted. And I think that served to be a little bit of an undercut for some guys up up the road a little ways, because I think I was in 22nd at that point and wound up 22nd or 23rd, and then wound up ultimately getting into P19. Of course, there was a lot of attrition as well. This track will punish you for doing silly things, and so that's really the trick, is to make sure you know, do most of your braking in a straight line, you don't overcook your turns. The hairpin is notoriously difficult to manage your braking coming into it, and to get on the accelerator the right way coming out of it. And as you saw, several guys kind of missed that, and there are a couple of other difficult turns on this track that will punish you really, really big time. So all in all, I can't complain. As a first outing for Sebring this season, that's definitely not too bad. I don't mind that at all. Looking forward to the next race, which where is it? It's at Long Beach. Now, Long Beach will be an interesting track with you know, anywhere from 45 to 47 cars on it. Again, that's got some really interesting sections on it, and a very difficult hairpin that I am sure will eat its fair share of cars in this particular series. Anyway, I do appreciate you watching. Please remember to click like or subscribe. I love comments on the video, so if you like what you saw or you have some suggestions for the next video or the next race, feel free to comment on it, and I will definitely respond back. Until next time, I know. Spaß machen im Sport.